I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them. They turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my words to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of wind and flame, I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them. My hand will save. Finest bread I will provide, till their hearts are satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart.
So let us prepare ourselves for the Eucharistic celebration. Please stand, and then you may turn to the back. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Jaime died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory.
O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees, when I look down from a lofty mountain grandeur and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art.
Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant, Jaime, also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Please be seated and listen to the Word of God.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The just man, though he die early, shall be at rest. For the age that is honorable comes not with the passing of time, nor can it be measured in terms of years. Rather, understanding is the hoary crown for men, and an unsullied life, the attainment of old age. He who pleased God was loved. He who lived among sinners was transported, snatched away, lest wickedness pervert his mind or deceit beguile his soul. For the witchery of paltry things obscures what is right, and the whirl of desire transforms the innocent mind. Having become perfect in a short while, he reached the fullness of a long career, for his soul was pleasing to the Lord. Therefore, he sped him out of the midst of wickedness. But the people saw and did not understand, nor did they take this into account. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side. With your rod and your staff that give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God through Jesus bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven. And the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me will never die. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
It was about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon, because of an eclipse of the sun. Then the veil of the temple was torn down the middle. Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." And when he had said this, he breathed his last. Now there was a virtuous and righteous man named Joseph, who, though he was a member of the council, went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. After he had taken the body down, he wrapped it in a linen cloth and laid him in a rock-hewn tomb in which no one had yet been buried. At daybreak, on the first day of the week, the women took the spices they had prepared and went to the tomb. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb, but when they entered, they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were puzzling over this, behold, two men in dazzling garments appeared to them. They were terrified and bowed their faces to the ground. They said to them, "Why do you seek the living one among the dead? He is not here, but he has been raised." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated for our reflections, for our homily. Today, we gather to pay our final respects and bid a fond farewell to a gentle and much-loved person, Jaime. On behalf of Christ the King Church, I extend condolences to Otter family, their relatives, and their friends. We are praying for you during this difficult time. So we began our liturgy welcoming Jaime to this church for the last time. We bless her body with the holy water at the narthex area that recalls Jamie's baptism when Randy and Sue, her parents, brought her to the church, sharing with her their faith in Jesus Christ. As we join in prayer today, let us be consoled by the thought that there would be no more pain and no more just lying there and suffering and then sleeping and then suffering some more. While it is true that death is the final enemy all of us must face, it is also true that for us Christians, like Jaime, death becomes at the same time a friend for which we pray, a gateway for which we yearn. So in the first reading from the Book of Wisdom that you chose for this liturgy, it says, "The age that is honorable comes not with the passing of time, nor can it be measured in terms of years. Jaime was grateful for her life, even if it was shorter than we wished. God gave her wonderful parents, Randy and Sue. Jeff, a loving husband who went out of his way to spend some time with her. Blake, Brian, Ava, her three children, and Ellie, her dog. She was full of life, loved her faith, very compassionate, loved people, and wore a huge smile. The reading says, "He who pleased God was loved." Jaime was loved. In the last few years of her life, it was Jaime who needed your hands. Always ready to help, she now needed help. And you rose to occasion. While this was difficult for Jaime, she might be grateful about how her family members had done to her, what they could and when they could, to make her life a little easier, even as it became more difficult. Since the day Jaime died, you might have felt separated from her. Paul, in the second reading, speaks of what might separate us from the love of Christ. Death is among the things Paul considers, but death does not separate us from Christ. In fact, death from this world can lead us to the fullness of God's presence in heaven, for our hope is full of immortality. We might fear the consequences of sins, but not according to our sins does God deal with us. Rather, God did not spare his own Son, Jesus Christ, but handed him over for us all. Jesus died for us. There is the love of Christ. There is our hope. It is Jesus' sacrifice on the cross for the forgiveness of our sins that we celebrate in this Mass. When we offer a funeral Mass, the intention for that Mass is for our loved ones' time in purgatory to be swept. When we offer a Mass intention for our loved one, it is not just a way of honoring them. It is to pray for them in purgatory. We don't know how long one is in purgatory, but it is a good place even though it involves pain. It is good because if we are there, we know we will make it to heaven. Purgatory exists to cleanse us of the effects of our sins. So today's Mass is offered for Jaime. We also pray for ourselves. The loss of a loved one can feel like a burden. We might feel burdened with grief. How do we find rest from the burden of grief? There is a saying, time heals all wounds. The grieving process naturally takes time, but what really gives us rest from our grief? Hope. St. Paul does not want us to be left unaware about those who have fallen asleep, so that we may not grieve like those who have no hope. For he promised us that if we believe that Jesus died and rose so too, will God, through Jesus Christ, bring with him those who have fallen asleep? And because we believe this, today we can celebrate Jaime's funeral Mass. What we actually celebrate today is hope. Hope that as we pray for Jaime, she will enter heaven. Hope that if she is in heaven, she will pray for us. Hope that one day, when we too depart, there would be people around here praying for us. So I would like to direct your attention to the tall white candle that stands beside Jaime's coffin. We call it the Paschal candle because we light it firstly at Easter, last Holy Saturday, the Vigil Mass. And then you can see in that white candle the five grains of incense inserted in it, symbolizing the five wands of Jesus Christ, the two wands in his hands, the two in his legs, and the wand in his side. It is very symbolic that this Paschal candle stands beside the coffin during every funeral mass. It is almost as if Jesus is standing beside Jaime, looking up at his father and pleading on behalf of Jaime, saying, "Look, I bore these ones in my body for the salvation of Jaime. I suffered, I died, I rose again for her. Forgive her, Father, and take her to paradise." Also in the Paschal candle, above the five grains of incense, there is the first letter of the Greek alphabet, Alpha. And below the five grains of incense, there is the last letter, Omega. In other words, Jesus is the beginning and end of all that we do and say. If it were not for Jesus' suffering, those five ones, dying and his rising, life, our life, would not have any meaning. But Jesus was the beginning and end of all our lives. It is he who gives meaning to our lives, especially in times of suffering. This candle reminds us that Jaime has gone to heaven. That is where all good people go. And Jaime was a very good, faith-filled person. So to end, I would like to share this story about a pastor who speaks about heaven. He goes around saying to people that there are no hospitals in heaven. There are no doctors in heaven. There are no nurses in heaven. And there are no ambulances in heaven. What the pastor meant to say was, there's no more suffering and there's no more pain. That is heaven. And it is to this place of rest and happiness Jaime is gone. Let us assist her now through our prayers so that Christ can make up for what is lacking in Jaime's life. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Please stand. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. In baptism, Jaime received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Our sister Jaime was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom, especially Jaime. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Jaime seek comfort and consolation, heal their pain, and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Jaime. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your son's coming. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated and prepare ourselves for the offertory.
Imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine, yeah. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine, yeah. I can only I'll be able to speak it all. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. I can only imagine.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church. Please stand. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant, Jaime, may be taken up into glory with your Son. In whose great mystery of love, we are all united through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, Eduardo, his assistant, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Jaime, whom you have called today from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, please stand. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Please kneel. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
In just a moment, we will be invited to receive Holy Communion. If you are Catholic and spiritually prepared to receive communion, you will be guided through the communion lines. If you are not Catholic, or if you are Catholic but not spiritually prepared to receive communion, you may either go through the communion line with your arms across your chest like this, and Father will give you a blessing instead, or you may simply remain in the pew and pray with us from there.
I am the bread of life. You who come to me shall not hunger, and who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father beckons, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. The bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. And if you eat of this bread, you shall live forever. You shall live forever. And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. Unless you eat of the flesh of the Son of Man and drink of his blood, and drink of his blood, you shall not have life within you. And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. And I will raise you up, and I will
snare of the fowler.
Let us pray. Please stand. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Jaime, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. I would like to invite Brian.
Right on. Hope your day is full of sparkle and shine. And you go, girl. If you know Jaime, you know these were some of her favorite go-to one-liners. My name is Brian Busby, Jaime's brother-in-law, and apparently was recently promoted to one of her children. So that's an honor I'm happy to have. My family and I would love to say thank you to everyone who could be here today to show their love and support for Jaime and for us. Jaime was born on August 27th, 1978, to Randy and Sue Effhauser, and waiting for her was big sister Danielle. She was a daughter, sister, granddaughter, niece, cousin, aunt, friend, godmother, and mom. She was an adventurous little girl who loved playing with all of her cousins, three-wheeling in Sycamore Creek, and spending weekends at Roosevelt Lake. Tonto, or up on the rim. She grew up playing softball, running track, and was an avid swimmer for many years for the city of Mesa, and eventually passed that love of swimming on to Abby, Blake, and Ava. Jamie met her best friend, Anne, when they were kids, and they spent many years causing a ruckus everywhere that they ventured, like church, sorry, Father, around the neighborhood, school, and something about Nogales. I think that's something we'll learn about later. She spent many years as a teenager working at Saba's Western Wear and Serrano Mexican food restaurants. Then she began to be an adult. She worked at the City of Mesa in the Engineering Public Relations Department, then later moved to Marketing Communications Specialist. She even helped manage her father, Randy's Plumbing Company, for years. Jamie met Jeff and became friends during their junior high years, but fast forward past high school graduation, when the two ran into each other at a good old Country Thunder reconnected, and the rest was history. In 2002, they tied the knot and then welcomed Abby, Blake, and Ava. I'd also like to mention that the single most selfless act Jamie took on in life and had the pleasure of being part of was being a surrogate and bringing Finley into this world. Blake says about his mom, "She was my hero. She never complained and put others before herself. No matter how busy things got, she always made time for the people she cared about and showed us that family comes first. My mom was always the loudest one cheering for my siblings and I at events like football games or swim meets and award ceremonies. I just know how excited and proud she was to watch us do what we loved." Sue and Randy's favorite story to tell about Jamie is when she was little, she always wanted to sleep in the bed with them. They tell her she couldn't because she had her own big girl bed. When they would get up in the morning, she would be laying on the floor at the foot of their bed with her blanket and little pillow, sound asleep. Jeff's most fond memory was from their honeymoon in Jamaica. They had gone to dinner, and at the dinner there was an auction by the pool. They were having a great time when she had a grand idea that she wanted to bid on something. Now, according to Jeff, they didn't have any idea what they were bidding on. And they just knew that there were statues, trips, and all sorts of things. And at one point, an unknown item came up for bid. It was a picture of something. Even the auctioneer had no idea what it was. Now, if you know Jamie, I'm sure you know what happened next. She placed a bid. Jeff said, "What are you doing?" She said, "It's fine. We aren't going to win it anyway." So she began to bid more and more, and each time the bid got to be $50, and there was no more bids. Jeff then tells her, "You're going to win it." Mom said, "No, I wasn't the last bid." Jeff said, "No, you definitely were the last bid." Once the hammer went down, the auctioneer pointed right at Jamie and said, "She won." They were both laughing so hard, they went and got the tube and looked at the picture inside it. They laughed and laughed. Jeff loved that carefree side of Jamie. He will never forget that night. He still has the picture in the same tube it came in 22 years ago. Abby's favorite memory was from a time when her mom and her had to pick up medication at Walgreens. That was like 45 minutes away from where they were, and Abby decided that she would take the long drive, and she would get out her phone and put the camera on and film them doing carpool karaoke. Abby then edited it to look like one of those Jimmy Kimmel videos. Some of the memories that Ava had with her mom that she will cherish forever is when they would go to the car wash blasting country music and then would always get some sort of drink afterwards. Those things brought so much joy to Ava, and she would watch her mom's smile just grow more and more. Another thing Ava can't forget are the times when they would try to sing along with songs but sing the complete wrong lyrics. Ava says, it always made me laugh, no matter how many times she had to correct her. I love my mom and will continue to do so for the rest of my life. Now, my wife, Danielle, will be forever grateful for her sister for showing her the ropes on how to be a mom. If Danielle was ever in a panic because one of the girls had a rash or a bump, a fever, a cough, couldn't sleep, wouldn't eat, or were throwing up all around the Grand Canyon, Jaime was the first one she ran to or called for advice or help, because Danielle knew she could always count on her little sis to rescue her, and she would every single time. And I have a short memory of Jaime as well. When we first met, in the first few years, I would say, she was not a fan. And she let me know it multiple times. And she read me the riot act all the way up until we got married, I believe. But she was protective of her sister. And through the years, Jaime and I became so close. She is a light to me. And any of you know her, if the camera was on, no matter how bad she felt, her smile and her light would come out for the camera, even up until the last days. And I will miss her very much. In closing, our family wishes to extend their heartfelt thanks to family members, friends, caregivers, staff at Hospice of the Valley, and their loving and caring support during her final days. Jamie's legacy will live on through the stories she shared and the countless lives she touched. She will be deeply missed, but forever remembered for her radiant smile and unconditional love she gave to all that knew her. And she would definitely say, may your days be forever filled with sparkle and shine.
Please stand. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Jaime. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. Angels lead you to Abraham's embrace. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Grant eternal rest unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her, receive her soul, and present her to God the Most High.
To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Jaime, your servant. In the sight of this world, she is now dead. In your sight, may she live forever. Forgive whatever sins she committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant her everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. In peace, let us take our sister Jaime to her place of rest. Thanks be to God.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. The many dangers, toils, and snares I have already thus far, and grace will lead me home. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sing God's praise, then when